Hi, welcome back to our new lecture. Now we are review the main points regarding to the utility scale solar photovoltaic power plant. As you see this document, this is from International Finance Corporation, and this document consists of a lot of tables, a lot of photos, a lot of formations regarding all the requirement and auto understanding all the topics of the solar system. So this document consists of 216 pages. So I just review in shortcut. As you see, we have here a lot of figures, a lot of photos, a lot of analysis, a lot of abbreviations that you needed to use in this system. So also we have here, for example, International Energy Agency. We have here direct current, direct normal radiation. Well, this is internal rate of return. Also we have European norm, environmental impact assessment, environmental health and safety, digital signal processing, etc. So this is very useful document. You can review it and you can take a lot of information from this. So we have a very important question in this sector, that how to pass a solar inspection. Make sure to document any as-built. You see, we have as-built, so must be checked the as-built document. Changes to your installation before the inspection. For example, suppose you make changes to plans already approved by the building department. In that case, an inspector may approve them on the fly, but more often they won't. In this case, you will have to resubmit your plans so that the inspectors copy match the approved plan exactly. This is very important thing. What we're understanding from this one, it means that when we are going to inspection, we must be going to check all the document for the as-built. Otherwise, if there is any change in this document, we must be follow and find the last approved before we are going to inspection. In general, the solar system consists of solar module and inverter, and also we have batteries and AC panels. So this is for general. We have here PV modular standards. We have a lot of standards. The important these standards are IEC 61215, IEC 61646, so IEC 61730, IEC 63 64/4/41. This is protection against electrical shock. And also we have IEC 61701. This is resistance to salt, mist and corrosion. We have another standards. The important things that we are must be looking at times when we are going to inspect the solar system, even in the home, in buildings, in a plan, that the performance ratio, which is a parameter commonly used to qualify PV panels performance, so usually expressed as percentage. So the performance ratio provides us to compare plants or to compare our system over a given time, independent of the plant or capacity or solar resources. So a plant with a high PR is more efficient at converting solar radiation into useful energy. The PR is defined as the ratio between the exported AC yield and the theoretical yield that would be generated by the plant if the modules converted radiation received into useful energy according to their rated capacity. So the full definitions of performance ratio is given and IEC 61724, which is photovoltaic system performance monitoring guideline for measurement, data exchange and analysis. It may be expressed as so performance ratio equal to IEC yield kilowatt hour multiplied by 1 kilowatt per meter square over the DC installation capacity kilowatt per meter multiplied by plane or array for foundation kilowatt per meter square multiplied by 100%. Also, the fundamental components of the AC power output from the inverter divided by the DC power output, which is this efficiency PAC over PDC. And we have here this is very important chart that explains to us the inverter efficiency percentage against the ratio of output power to the inverter's ratio or rated capacity. So we have high efficiency, medium efficiency, low efficiency, and this can we check our inverter during our inspection. Also, the capacity factor of the PV power plant, or usually expressed as a percentage, is the ratio of the actual output over a period of a year, and its output had operated at nominal power the entire year. So as described by the formula, capacity factor equal to energy generated per annual kilowatt per kilowatt hour over 8760 hours per annual multiplied by installed capacity, which is the value kilowatt P. Here we have very important items that when we are going to inspect it, we must be checked. This is, for example, this is the picture and this is the comment. Here, heavy soldering in desert conditions needs to be considered as a part of the operation and maintenance strategy. And also here, regarding to this one, this is poor DC cable management. Here we have a gland problem. Here we have glands should be used for all cables, not from some of them. As you see here, we have a drainage for this one. Also, we must be check all the plastic conduit. This is very important. And also, this cable should be protected from sharp metallic eggs. We must be not doing like this one. And also, regarding to the landscape or residing, and must be the area always clean. As you see here, we have a lot of accident. All these accident, most of them by bad connection. And you see like this one here, for example, this cable not protected and maybe damaged from time to time until it will be make a big spark. And you see here also, we have bad connection for the DC cables. As you see here, maybe all the plant will be destroyed due to very simple reason, and maybe some wire damage and caused all these losses of the plants and of the project. So you must be going when you are inspect. You must be check all the cables, glands, connections, wires. Also, you can use a thermal scan image to check all the connection loses and to find all the overheating, overloaded wires and etc. Check all the wires according to the our standards for the electrical connections and termination rigs and etc. As you see here, it's a lot of distortion because most of them due to the electrical or due to the bad connection due to the for the electrical wiring system. Thank you very much. See you in the next lecture.